So we're back at our smart home takeover. We've got Ross from RS Electrix behind us, busily working away. What is he doing, Gordon?
We're changing the consume unit today, Gary. Now, we're going to go into the reasons why we're changing the consume unit, because what we set out to do was install an EV charger, and they're supposed to be really easy.
Yeah, we are. So we're going to give you four reasons why the board behind us is being changed, as well as looking at the equipment we're going to install as well.
So we went for a Schneider Easy 9 consume unit, mainly because of its good looks. This is going in the client's hallway. We could have obviously fitted another additional consume unit just for the EV charge point, but that would have been a little bit unsightly. But we're using this upgrade opportunity to improve some of the challenges we found in the installation. And let's remember, the original consume unit didn't have any spare wires either.
Yeah, it was also made of plastic and had AC RCCBs within it. And now we've got A-type RCBOs, meaning we've got better protection for modern installations as well as selectivity.
Yeah, let's remember that previous consumer is no longer in production as well, so that would again be a challenge even changing those. We also went for surge protection, so again, an upgrade, a great opportunity to add some additional features to the installation and protect all of the electronics that we've added, including the car itself.
So the board will need to be isolated and made safe before all the circuits can be removed. So we're knocking off the circuit breakers and the RCCB, then the main switch, and then we're going to go outside and isolate the tails from the 100 amp switch outside and lock it off.
Yeah, it's lucky that I've got fitted in the existing tails. A lot of installations don't have them. You may have to that fitted in advance or get the DNO out to disconnect the supply during this process.
We've got a lot of circuits in this consumer unit, so it's important that we identify them all. The first circuit going to be the new circuit, which is our EV charging point. It's a heavy loaded circuit and will be nearest the main switch.
Yep. Oh, there's the last time we'll hopefully see those wood screws that have been used to hold the front of the consumer on, I think, from when it was originally installed, judging by the quality of the rest of the installation that we found here.
And as we look inside the consumer, you can see, first of all, there's a lot of circuits, but it's not the neatest. I expect Ross to return this in a much better state than what we've currently got it in.
So the first job with the Easy 9 board is to configure it for surge protection. So we need to make a few changes, the main one being the neutral connection to the bus bar. So that needs rerouting. That did flummox us a little bit at first, especially when you look at the live bus bar as well, because that has to route itself underneath the neutral. But yeah, we figured it out, a relatively easy process once you've read the instructions.
That's always a key thing, isn't it, to read those instructions, because it was very easy to do once you've read the instructions. So we're now in the process of actually disconnecting everything within the board. But before we can go about that, obviously we've confirmed the layout. So you'll see a lot of marking up processes that Ross does now.
Yeah, the last thing you want to do is reconnect the board or start reconnecting the board and not know which cable goes where. Is this the bit where the customer gets a bit nervous, Gary?
I would always suggest at this time it's when the Wi-Fi has been off for a small period of time and the angst has started. And it's always nice now perhaps to hand over the invoice, because I would imagine they'll be keen to see the electricity return to the installation.
Yeah, so there's one thing we'll have to do here is obviously once Ross has labelled up, is we're probably going to need to gain some additional length on all those conductors, aren't we? Because we're going to have to reroute them for this new board.
Yeah, nobody likes to put a lot of other connections within the consumer unit, so in other words, a joint. So if you can move it, and Ross will, I think he'll move it up a little bit, it just adds the length, making sure that obviously the new connections are solid cables into breakers, neutral bars, and CPC connections into earth bars.
Yeah, so we're lucky here, this is a dot and dab wall, so Ross is just removing some of the plasterboard for the new position. He's marked the wall with the new positions he's going to bring the cables in.
So this means also that we're probably going to have to replace the metering tails at some point as well. So out comes the fabric of the building, and now we're just going to move them up. You can see how much length now we've gained in order that we can fit the Easy 9.
Yeah, you're right. A much better approach than joining those cables. I don't know where you'd do it. In this installation, you'd be ripping that floor up again upstairs.
Yeah, nobody wants to do that. Made a nice job of this. He taped up the ends. This was new to me. And then stripped back to the taped area, put his CPC sleeving on, or earth sleeving, and then retaped them again so they couldn't come off. I thought that was a real clever little trick. So you just watch him here. It slides on the sleeve in, and then he'll retape the top of these so it doesn't pull off.
All right, yeah, that's a good tip. Yeah, again, he's got a uniform length as well with that. Just his marking process, and again, you can see how he's marked the circuit numbers on the outer sheath of the twin and earth cables as well.
Yeah, and it's all about the prep. The straighter they are now and the longer they are now, the easier it is when we start dressing it into the new board. Always find once the new board is on the wall, you can take a deep breath then, because it's the enjoyable part of reconnecting.
Yeah.
It's all the prep work first. So new tails have gone in. And we're now going to introduce the Easy 9 board. And again, you watch, he's still trying to get them in the right order for the layout of the circuit breakers within the distribution or consumer unit.
Yeah, it is quite cosy in there once you add all those RCBOs in there. And you'll also notice our new cable coming in on the right-hand side for the EV charger with a metal capping that's in place for that.
It's also got to address the alarm cable that was used to feed the, which now is a smart doorbell, and at some point I'm sure he'll oversleeve that as well.
Yeah, again, another problem we picked up on our initial inspection of this project.
I always like to think when you take off the consumer unit cover and look at it, you make a lot of assumptions about the wiring within the installation itself, and Ross took a lot of time to make sure that each of his conductors was dressed neatly into the board.
Yeah, he's making a fantastic job there.
He is, yeah. So all the CPCs going in, and then he'll systematically work his way to the next conductor. But look at that. That's a lot of effort gone into that.
Yeah, so we're now going to start introducing the RCBOs.
Yeah, so RCBOs come in, and now we start connecting those up and dressing them round. Again, he spent a lot of time making sure that everything looked neat. You see him dressing round the neutral connections, which come from the RCBO into the neutral bar.
Yeah, so I like the way he did that. Yeah, so he did them in order. So a lot of people just sometimes just stack the board fully loaded with all the breakers and then attempt to do this. But there's another good top tip from Ross there.
Yeah. Okay, so here we go. And he's trying to make sure that he can hide those neutral fly leads once they're all connected. Ferrulling ends as well when he trimmed them back, which was nice to see.
Yeah, because they're a fine stranded conductor. So you do need to do something with the ends if you're going to shorten them.
And once he's got more connected, I'll just pull the camera back in real time. You'll be able to see how beautifully made those neutrals from the RCBOs with the ferruled ends in the actual neutral terminations itself. So, look at that. That's pretty neat. Do you agree?
Yeah, so now I've just got to deal with those functional and earth connectors. There's not many RCBOs still have them, but these ones do in this Easy 9 board. So again, he's put one into each individual way, so it goes through the earth terminal corresponding with the RCBO.
And he's also ferruled the ends. So now it's just a case of getting the tails in, and those are those flexi tails, so they were a lot easier to pull in, 19 strands. And you see now we're just going to connect new tails into the 100 amp switch. So we're very close now to seeing what the finished product does look like. It's all these little things that take the time, and you think you're there, and then it's obviously the tails, etc. There we go. So prior to testing, so we've still got to test the installation. That's the finished board from RS Electric. But we did say about this, didn't we, Gordon?
Yeah, so you're just adding some additional insulation to that alarm cable that feeds the out to the bell chime. So again, now just making that additional insulation because we've got two voltage bands within the consumer unit.
Putting the bus bar in, just making sure everything's correct before we go on, and obviously look at that testing process. And obviously what's going to come next is obviously the torque settings of the actual devices, and we're going to confirm those.
Yeah, so again, just get those the torque settings, so they are all marked on the shroud that goes over the bus bar at the bottom, which is good. We like to see that, so easy to find for anybody in the future. So just going along and checking those all the torque settings.
And as we pan back now at the finished Easy 9 consumer unit, you can see it looks considerably better than the one that we had to start with. It's also alleviated some of those problems. We've added an additional circuit, we've got a spare way, it's metallic.
Yeah, and we've got that surge protection.
Now, as always, once you're finished, you're not finished. So people think now it's just turn it on and walk away. There's some extensive tests that Ross is going to have to carry out, and I see he's using the Mitrell 3152 in order to do so. So just zeroing up his leads. And he goes through the full testing process. We'll just show a sample of what he has to do. But this was a few hours after the install as well. People think that's it, the board is on the wall, we're finished, and that's not the case.
Yeah, and again, obviously, we're not a how-to channel, so this is not how to change your own consumer unit, and this is probably one of the reasons you wouldn't want to change your own consumer unit, because you probably don't have the right test gear to confirm that it's being done properly and the installation is as you would need it to be.
And he's took ownership of all of these circuits now, so we're testing a ring final circuit at the minute. He's having to prove that all the rings within the installation are a ring. I think there was only one. They had a couple of radials for things like the kitchen and the downstairs area, but he's got to prove that every one of those circuits is correct before he leaves it.
Yeah, and he's testing this from the midpoint of the ring. You don't have to do it at the consumer unit, do you, Gary?
No, it was nice to see, and it was a better way. He didn't want to disturb all those lovely cables he's put in, so he's doing it from one of the socket outlets with the links, etc. So as he goes through, and what's nice about this, you can actually confirm which of the tests you're carrying out. So if this being an R2 test, so that's a little R2 test, obviously you're going to do R1 plus R2, RN and R1 as well. So as you look here, we go now for R1 plus R2. So this is the actual reading that we should confirm by a calculation to prove it's on a ring. So he's got his links in place now. Opposite line and opposite CPC connected. And you got 0.33. So we take our little R1, little R2 value, and mathematically we've got exactly the same reading proving it was a ring final circuit. But it doesn't stop there, does it, Gordon?
No, well, no, you've got to, obviously, that's where we brought our EV charger cable down. And hopefully, yeah, the client doesn't want to live with that, yeah, that urban look that's popular now. No, they want the wall putting back together.
I don't think many people are thinking when standing on a forecourt about an EV car, their mind drifts back to their own consumer unit thinking, I may need to alter it.
Yeah, you're right, Gary. And Ross has done a fantastic job for us here in changing this unit. We picked this one because of its good looks. You know, we could have some other options here. We could add another small consumer unit. But we used the opportunity of the upgrade to correct some of the other issues we found in the installation. Check out our first video when we first walked into this house of some of the things that concerned us, and the previous consumer unit was there.
On that first tour, the dumb home tour, I didn't notice that wall had been chased at that stage. So what's gone on there?
Well, no, obviously we couldn't, yeah, we can't perform miracles to install an EV charge point, and the charge point in this case is all the way at the back of the house. So check out the video we made that explains the problem before we started the installation. But we've also made another video that shows you the journey from the meter cabinet outside through the consumer unit and follows the cable run and some of the choices we made there to get that EV charge point installed.
As always, we're interested in your comments. Are you an electrical contractor that recommends maybe a separate consumer unit? Leave your thoughts below. Are you the type of electrician that would like to offer an upgrade to the consumer unit and maybe he's finding some resistance to that because of the increased cost, when originally all they wanted was a fancy outside socket in order to charge their EV? Are you a customer? Have you been recommended to have a consumer unit upgrade and at the time thought, well, why am I doing that? And maybe it's a little bit clearer now after watching this video. If you can leave all those thoughts below and comments, we'll try and get back to as many as we can.